Hi everyone, LazyFire here. Welcome back to Battlefield 4 Multiplayer. Today we are on Paracel Storm and we're making fun of a guy who said his job in the army was special forces. Yeah, literally those words, can't make it up. Anyways, the actual point of the video is to talk about the mobile anti-aircraft gun. This is the last of the vehicles we really need to cover in this series, as the rocket truck is kind of boring to watch and I did do a couple seconds on it. That's all it really deserves, there's not a lot there. But the mobile anti-aircraft gun, by comparison, is very, very popular. It's got a lot to talk about, so we're going to cover it today. Now, the first thing you should know is that the mobile anti-aircraft gun, or MAA, came over from Battlefield 3. I don't really remember it that well in Battlefield 3. I remember it was on a few different maps, but I mostly remember it from one late DLC map, where it was pretty freaking baller in that. But in Battlefield 4, it's got an upgrade. It's much, much better now. Part of that is because of the way things are balanced a little bit more towards ground troops, as they are going to make the majority of any player on any server. DICE really went all out and gave them a couple different advantages, and one was giving an MAA to them on almost every single map. There's only three in the base game I can think of, those being Flood Zone, Seizure Shanghai, and of course Operation Locker, which does not feature vehicles, save for the occasional airdropped ATV that might make it. And those three all have helicopters, but they do not have mobile anti-aircraft guns. Now, by comparison, every other map has a mobile anti-aircraft gun in some regard. On a map like Hunan Resort, or this one, it's actually out in the middle of a map, and you have to hold a point if you want to be able to spawn into it. But on maps like Zavid and Dawnbreaker, it actually spawns in your spawn area, so you can just grab it from there and go on a tear if you feel the need to. Now, there's some maps where that ladder works a lot better because you can just sit in your spawn and kind of just take people down as they try to get out of their spawn area, and it's a very popular tactic. I don't really believe in that. I think all vehicles should kind of try to be frontline vehicles when they can, and the mobile anti-aircraft gun is actually pretty good as a frontline vehicle, which is why it's sad to see a lot of people just sit in the back of their spawn and fire this thing off at anything that clinks by. And, you know, they might do some damage or they might take a thing out, but they're not going to do a lot for their team. By contrast, by sitting up here, I'm actually in the middle of a lot of action. I have a lot of access to things. So I can definitely hit this guy with my 20mm cannon, which is the starter cannon, does about 2 points of damage. There's also the 30mm cannon, which does slightly more damage, but fires a little bit slower. There are also my secondary weapons. These are my passive radar missiles. They're kind of like the active radar missiles, we'll talk more about those later, but they're closer to heat seekers. You just have to maintain your lock on whatever vehicle it is, and then fire, like I do here. Just maintain the lock, and I'll get the points. I got a mobility kill here, then I do a bit more damage. He is still up. I realize at this point that he actually has people repairing him constantly, which is why he's able to stay in the air. Now, this is actually there was a nerf on helicopters recently, and this is pre that nerf. But you can see here, even with my zoomed in optics, I'm not really hitting these guys too effectively. There are some people who can do this a lot better than me. They weren't in the server at the time, so I just felt the need to make sure the enemy team didn't grab this. As we saw, they were all over the B area when I took it, so it was definitely at risk of going into enemy hands. But for the most part, yeah, that's it. I mean, this thing has countermeasures similar to tanks. Actually, they're all the exact same thing as tanks. But we should talk a bit more about their secondary weapons. So the MAA has some interesting secondary weapons. Several of them are unique to ground vehicles in the MAA. One of those is, of course, heat seekers, which function exactly like helicopter heat seekers. Watch how fast I take out this transport chopper, by the way. Gone. It's gone. Anyways, the weapons like the heat seekers, you know, like I said, they function exactly like they do in planes. You just maintain your lock and fire and then look away. The passive radar missiles are also going to appear on murder boats, so they're not really on their own. And then there's the active radar missiles. We'll talk more about those, like I said a second ago, in a second. But there's also the Zuni rockets, which we've seen on LAVs before, actually. They're, you know, rockets that you fire, dumbfire rockets that you shoot at the ground, basically, and do massive splash damage. People use this in the 30mm cannon on the MAA to basically make it an extra tank. You can take out other vehicles with this thing. Now, I should mention that this thing does not have as much armor as, say, an LAV or anything like that, but it can still take a beating, especially against infantry, where the 20mm and 30mm cannons really, really excel. Killing infantry with one of these things is not very difficult. It's actually one of the more fun parts of it. Of course, I could also have switched out my different optic types. I could have gone with the night vision or the heat vision, as they were. But I keep going with zoom. I still feel like it's the best option in a lot of regards with vehicles and zooming in and everything like that and trying to acquire targets. The other ones get really susceptible to washing out or not really looking good. I can't always identify stuff with them, unfortunately, because they're a little grainy. So I generally rely on the zoom optics. Well, Dr. Strangelove's going to come over and heal me up here. Now, with this being sort of the last vehicle to talk about in this game, it's worth mentioning that there have been some balance changes to the MAA. Part of that was kind of getting the 30mm and 20mm cannons a bit more in line with each other. It just happened recently. And the other one was over the anti-aircraft secondary weapons, especially the active radar missiles, which we're now, I think, ready to talk about. Active radar missiles are one of the earlier unlocks for the MAA. Of course, not the first unlock, but rather an early one. And they are stupid. They're just really stupid easy to use. They're, at their very core, kind of dumbfire rockets. You point them in the direction of the thing you want to die, and then you pull the trigger. So when you do that, what happens is if the MAA fires out a rocket, or a missile really, that will travel forward pretty much indefinitely, and if it crosses paths with a helicopter or plane or anything like that, it immediately locks on with them, and then will track to it and just slam into it and blow it up. Well, it won't kill it outright. It usually takes about two to do that, but there's some extenuating circumstances here. So with the mobile anti-aircraft guns, active radar missiles, one of the circumstances you have to remember here is that when the game first came out, if you got hit with one of those things, your vehicle would flip on its side. Yeah. That can be a real major problem, especially if you're flying low, trying to get under or behind something before the MAA can target you. That can really end up killing a lot of people, because recovering from that sideways fall was not easy. I spotted it. Now, maybe the bigger issue was the number you got. You got six of them to start. That was two to fire at any given time, and then four more to be fired. You know, you could reload. Basically have a near infinite number by the time the next helicopter got in your area, you probably had reloaded all your stuff. Oh, and here's how useless the stealth jet is against a boat. Yeah, just a couple points. I was just looking for targets at that time. So anyways, the big thing about active radar missiles was also, besides those other two factors, the fact that the cone that it aimed at, so if you fell within the cone of influence, as it were, in front of the active radar missile, was way too big. It was just gigantic, to the point where people could have basically look at the very, very edge of the aiming reticle at something miles and miles away, and it would still lock on when it got there. Just absolutely too much, and the distance at which the cone extended to was a little extreme as well. So this led to a lot of complaining, I think rightfully as well, by a lot of players, that it just made it very, very difficult to fly any vehicles in a lot of maps, because the cannon themselves, the 20mm and the 30mm cannons, both have some really, really good range. And one of the more common tactics people use, as I've said before, is to sit in their spawn, just basically as far back as they can get, where people can't really target them or aim at them or even maybe jihad jeep them, and just basically knock down everything and anything that comes out of the other team's spawn. One of the maps this is really common on is called Land King Dam. We saw it when I did the tank video, actually. And in that map, it's not uncommon to basically get shot down the second you take off, because the other team has a mobile anti-aircraft gun, basically in spawn, just like your team does, and they're just not going to let you leave, because it just, you know, they can just shoot you down very, very quickly. So maps like that, not a huge fan of, when they don't really think about cover and terrain and everything like that. Just the ability to fight back against this thing really needs to be improved. not only on the infantry level, because like I said before, this thing can tear infantry members apart, but in terms of air vehicles, there's got to be some better options. I really think it does need the MAA, by the way, not the stealth jet, does need something of a nerf in addition to what it's already had, just to make some of the other vehicles a little bit more viable to fly on a map like this one. This guy's already abandoned his. Let's just fly right past it. Now, the active radar missiles have been nerfed pretty significantly, as I've mentioned before, so now you can only really carry 4 total, I believe. Might have actually gone down to 2, I think. And they do not flip you over anymore, which is very much appreciated, it turns out, by most of the community. They can actually fly without getting flipped over by one of the easier-to-use weapons. The cone of influence it has in front of itself has been greatly reduced to the point where you have to be fairly close. I haven't really seen anyone use an active radar missile since this patch, by the way. So I don't know how great this has gone, but it sounds like it's doing a little bit better than I thought it would. Now, you have to remember, the mobile anti-aircraft gun is technically, now, on paper, very important words to note there, it is the second least killed with vehicle in the game, or kills, it has the second lowest kills per minute. I think the next one was the attack chopper, or the first one is the attack chopper, I think after that it was the rocket chopper. But yeah, that's sort of the status it's in, is when you shoot somebody down with that thing, oftentimes you do not actually get the points for it. You'll get a note that they died or something like that, or you assisted, but the game will often tell them that they were killed in action rather than they were shot down by a mobile anti-aircraft gun. So some of the stats are skewed, but there are other people who are just really, really good, like ChronoJam, who is a goon who plays with us occasionally. He is really, really good in the mobile anti-aircraft gun, and he can just go out there and knock down people who are on the ground or in the air just alike, and just do a really fantastic job of just locking down an entire map, no matter where he goes. So, yeah, it's impressive to watch somebody who's good at these things just take them on and just do real work with them. But at the same time, you know, them playing with them a lot, man, I don't know how stupid I am that I fell for that. But them playing with them a lot means that you and other people like you who really want to use it and kind of learn it are going to have a harder time doing it. It's one of the easier ways to get some points in this game is to pilot one of the MAAs for a little while and just rack up a few kills and, you know, get some points going. I service started in probably like a day and a half of play, just not a lot of time to do it. It doesn't have a ton of unlocks. Has about as many unlocks as, say, your normal tank, but it levels up a little bit faster, it feels like. And it's a fun weapon to use, whether you're going to be shooting down helicopter pilots or trying to keep your sanity as wave after wave of infantry member fires a rocket at you or tries to C4 you or something. I really do end up using it more as an anti-infantry vehicle than I do use it for an anti-air vehicle. But, you know, that's me. It's also, like I said before, a really, really, really popular vehicle in this game that I had to wait, what, almost 2 months of playing this game before I could even get onto the thing long enough for it to count as something I could put into a video. That's insane. I got into it in Hainan Resort for a few minutes and I died. That was mostly my fault that I didn't try to run away from the situation, and I instead ran headlong into danger. On this map, it was more because B is a very popular point, and having a mobile anti-aircraft gun means it's going to be more difficult for people to come in off of the different islands or from the cruiser out there, or the carrier out there. I'm in a turn battle right now with a... There he is. Yeah, I was in a bit of a turn battle there. Sorry about that. Goodbye. That guy's going to slam into the ground any second now. So yes, the mobile anti-aircraft gun is really a fan favorite. People really enjoy using it, and I can see why, but it just makes it more difficult for someone who's trying to show off different aspects of the game to really play the game. I have no interest in sitting on a spawn screen and clicking the mobile anti-aircraft link over and over and over again until I get into it. That's not how that works. That's really boring to watch for you, and I'd rather have fun playing this game than thinking I have to show off this thing. So, yeah, I basically waited for my time to come, and here we are. Now, people grabbing it from spawn is also not, or sorry, grabbing it from a point when it spawns is also pretty common. I was very impressed that I even got the time to grab it. So, yeah, that was a whole thing. I was very impressed with that. You'd see my team is having a bit of a struggle at the moment. If I wasn't flying this thing, I probably would be a little bit more help. But right now, they don't have their second little bird. They only have their two planes and their one helicopter. And of course, they have a transport chopper as well, but I'm not really worried about him. We're actually down a couple of tickets, but this is about... Or, sorry, we're up a bunch of tickets. We're actually down points. This is about as close as we got to losing the entire night we played on this server. This is the furry server from previously, by the way. And right there, I got killed by the stationary AA. Now, the stationary AA, unlike the mobile anti-aircraft gun, was something that was featured on most maps in Battlefield 3. I can remember Caspian Border had a couple. What was it? Davin Van Peak had one, at the very least. It made it so people in helicopters couldn't just come back and destroy you and spawn. How effective that was is anyone's real guess, because I would still get destroyed by helicopters and spawn even when I was manning those things. In this game, they're automatic as well as manually run, but I've never really seen a manually run one. You notice how I got the Killed in Action logo there? That was because a lot of the time with the MAAs, as I've mentioned, it doesn't always track them correctly, so you get some of these moments where I was killed in action, but I was very clearly killed by someone or something. Don't know why. It just does that. And it's a very frustrating situation for a lot of players who play with the mobile anti-aircraft gun. It feeds back into the thing I was talking about earlier. Ugh, I can't believe we didn't get the guy down there. Oh well. God, I love the chat in this video, and the chat most of the night against this guy was absolutely fantastic. He was really dumb. Now, the mobile anti-aircraft gun, I've been talking a lot about helicopters versus the mobile anti-aircraft gun. It's very effective versus helicopters. They move a little bit slower, they're a bit easier to lead where you need to, but they're still, mobile anti-aircraft guns are still effective against jets. Jets, especially those taking turns, or when people have learned to lead them, they can be really easy prey for a mobile anti-aircraft gun. This is especially true if you think about when you use something like the active radar missiles, which are going to be able to just be fired straight at the plane and just knock it a couple times, take it down to half health, or even lower, probably mobility kill it, and in that drop it's going to make towards you, just knock it out of the sky. It has to be mentioned, though, that that's not always going to be the case. There's going to be times where you're not going to be able to hit it, or you're going to be out of missiles, so be wary. So, a little bit of a dangerous situation if you're going to engage a jet with a mobile anti-aircraft gun, because the attack jets, as we've seen in one of my previous videos, can absolutely screw you up. I've had a couple of those situations where, you know, flying a jet and dropping a couple bombs down onto a vehicle will end up killing the anti-aircraft gun. It's not as heavily armored as the different tanks or LAVs in the game, so it can still take some damage, but it's never going to take damage from, say, a light machine gun on top of a tank or anything like that. Get to fly a little bird again. This is feeling pretty good. I'm finally learning how to do this correctly. What you do is you get as high as you can, and then you get two guys to repair you, and then you only fire at people. But let's talk about your ability to fight one of these things from the air. Not great. That's why a lot of people use jets to take those things out, and if you're not careful, those things will take out a jet easily. Watch this guy just bail. I don't understand the concept that pubbies have. We've definitely, and by we I mean my team, has had those moments where the other team just absolutely forgets what they're doing, leaves their vehicle, and then just, you know, thinks that they're okay to just drive off. Not so much. That's how we got the little bird in the last little bird video, for example. But yeah, that's the mobile anti-aircraft gun. We have one more thing to talk about, Operation Dawnbreaker, which I have a video of. I've had a video of it for months now, actually, since before we started this. But I just really need to put it together and let people see that. And then we're done with educational videos for this game. It's been a fun ride. I really enjoy showing some of these things off to people who maybe not have the most interest in the world in playing the game, or were waiting for a PlayStation 4 or Xbox One before they played it, or were, you know, they're going to build a PC someday or something like that. It's a really fun game. I hope that comes across in a lot of the videos. I've been exceptionally lucky, according to pretty much everyone I've talked to, in that almost all the time I have a really stable connection. I have, you know, ease of use. I don't have choppy frame rates or anything like that. I'm in a good spot when I play this game. So if you expect everything to look exactly like it does when I play it, you might be in for a rude awakening if you haven't played it already. But, you know, hey, that's sort of how things work right now. Waiting for my ammo to regen. I actually got somebody the other day. I spawned into his helicopter, and he immediately drove us off the map. So far off, by the time I realized he wasn't using it as a route, that we were basically dead. And right there, I killed a guy, and somebody in my helicopter shot down the plane with a Stinger, I think. Very impressive stuff. Man, I love the little bird. But right there, watch this MAA. Doesn't even... There it goes. That is what happens when you get hit with the Zunis and the 30mm. I'm very impressed there. I thought that was an active radar, actually. But yeah, that's the end of the round. Thanks for watching, everyone. The MAA is now taken care of. We can talk about Dawnbreaker next and just kind of be done with this. But I do want to talk about Naval Strike, so stay tuned for that. That should be coming up as soon as I can get a couple rounds in there and get the idea of what's going on with it. So yeah, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.